Welcome to the Art of Money podcast with Art McPherson.
And this is the Art of Money podcast with Art McPherson and Luke McCarty. Artofmoneyradio.com for more information on the McPherson Financial Group or to schedule that initial complimentary consultation. We appreciate you listening. Now, let's get to the show. Welcome back to the Art of Money with Art McPherson. It's all powered by the McPherson Financial Group. 321-425-8550. Always online, artofmoneyradio.com. Did you see I hit the post right there? Man, my old school DJ skills. There's a stretch of black top I ain't never seen. Jameson Rodgers, we're listening to right now. Cold Beer Calling My Name, a collaboration with Luke Combs. Shined up the windshield
glass. Don't know where I have that song in my playlist.
This seems like a good boat song for you this summer.
Oh, yeah.
So he's an up-and-coming artist. He's one of those guys that you'll probably get to know over the next couple of years. He's a burgeoning country star. Grew up in Batesville, Mississippi. Played a little college baseball. He's collaborated with Hardy. Collaborated with Luke Combs. So we had the opportunity to sit down with Jameson Rodgers at a recent event. And, you know, the important part is, as we talk about his collaboration with Luke Combs, with Hardy, you know, they're more than just songwriters. They're all friends. So we asked him about the importance of surrounding yourself with people you trust.
I mean, people ask me all the time if I have any advice for people moving to Nashville, and I say, go out, find you a crew of writers and artists to come up with. You know what I mean? That's what I did. I didn't even know I was doing that at the time, but luckily I did. And I mean, if one person wins, so do you. You know what I mean? You win together, and it's just, I don't know, it's more fun that way.
It's the importance of surrounding yourself with people you trust, Art McPherson.
And that's exactly what we do here at McPherson Financial Group. We want all of our clients to be able to trust that we have their best interest, you know, whether we're talking about their portfolio, you know, how we allocate their money, how we protect the money for them, how we make sure that we're putting in all kinds of different investment strategies, that regardless of a good market, bad market, you know, we're making sure their money is protected, especially when we go through weird times. You know, these are kind of weird times right now where you're seeing interest rates move up dramatically in a very short period of time, inflation being really high out of the normal range, the cost of borrowing being really high right now. So we're seeing a lot of different things going on. But at the same time, we have record low unemployment. So it's just really weird. We've got a wide variety. I kind of call the stock market right now bipolar. You know, it has days where I feel like it could really rally this year. And then it has days where I'm like, are we going to see another 25 or 30% correction this year? You know, it's just one of those weird periods of time where you've got all kinds of fluctuations and all kinds of information. One week will look great, and the next week it looks like the world, you know, the sky is falling.
Yeah. And talk about trust and surrounding yourself with people you trust. Let's get specific with the McPherson Financial Group. Who are some of the people that we're going to meet?
Well, we have Mark Bernard. So he's a CPA, and he is there to make sure our clients are really taking advantage of the tax law. We don't do anything that's not in the code, but making sure you are just magnifying the write-offs you can do. You want to make sure that you're taking advantage of tax strategies that are out there that the IRS has defined as things you're allowed to do to minimize that tax bite when it comes to the end of the year. So we want to have our clients as tax efficient as we possibly can. We've got Luke McCarty, another fiduciary in the office besides myself. He's also a certified financial planner. So he makes sure that all of our plans work for our clients through retirement and making sure that our clients can have the confidence to know that their plan is going to work. It's going to survive them. And we're going to have a beautiful nest egg to go to their kids and their grandkids. And then we have all kinds of support staff here where we have Jessica Burgess, who is actually working with us for estate planning. So she is our attorney. So if our clients are financial planning clients, we can have them update their will or update their trust or actually have a will or trust created for them if they haven't had the opportunity to do that. And she's a great asset to our team. But then we have people like Susan or Pam. When everyone comes in the office, she's our receptionist, but she's always the one answering the phone 60% of the time or so. She's usually your first voice you hear. But one of the things that we always made a commitment to, and we'll do this forever, is when you call our office, you don't have to push a button. You will always have someone answer your call. So anybody that calls our office, they'll hear a live voice on the line saying hello. And if you don't, you've missed us. We don't take a lunch break. We're always here through the day. But if you've called after 5 o'clock, then we're gone.
You work hard, you play hard as well. 321-425-8550. Again, 321-425-8550. Or meet the team online when you visit artofmoneyradio.com. More from Jameson Rodgers, and he talked about the power of patience.
Dude, I mean, can't have a plan B. You know what I mean? If you got a plan B, you'll go to plan B. Mm-hmm. And so anything worth having is going to take time. That's just the facts. It takes what it takes. I don't know what else to tell you. You got to do it.
Does that happen a lot, Art McPherson? Somebody comes in and puts her portfolio in front of you and says, I want this to increase by this much in 6 weeks and go. And you're like, whoa, it doesn't work like that. We have to customize a plan.
Well, if they're really just interested in a short term like that, they're probably not a good fit for us, because we really want to develop that long term strategy for them, because we want to make sure they're not only doing good for 6 months, we want to make sure they're doing good for 6 years, 16 years, 30 years, right? So short term strategies are usually aggressive strategies, you know, where people are trying to take a lot of risk and get a great return and then kind of put that money on the sidelines. But really, you need all kinds of risk, and you need to know as a portfolio when you start. I mean, typically, Mark, people that walk in the door have more money right now than they've ever had in their full life, you know, so they're getting towards retirement time and they have that $2, $3, $4, or $5 million sitting in that portfolio now. And now they have to have it last for the rest of their life and invest more money than they've ever had their entire life. And it can't run out on them. Good luck with that.
321-425-8550, artofmoneyradio.com. One more clip here from Jameson Rodgers talking about something that you work with a lot, Art McPherson, and that's about the legacy that you want to leave behind.
I want to move people the way I've been moved with music. When I'm in my truck and I get chills, and or if I cry or if it makes me happy, that was kind of my goal when I started writing, just to kind of be that vessel for somebody else. You know, hopefully make the world a little better place, whether it's singing about a good time cold beer or getting somebody over a heartbreak. You know what I mean? It's all the above.
I mean, I don't know if you're going to sit around talking about heartbreak and cold beers in the McPherson Financial Group. I mean, maybe. It is important, Mark, that you do help people put their legacies together.
We do cry sometimes, right? So I've had people come in here and cry, not because of performance-related issues, but because of life, right? So a loved one passing away, or a problem with a daughter or a son, you know, and going through what I call those curveballs of life, where somebody has had major financial upheaval or they've had a loss. You know, we do have a lot of emotional issues. One of the things that Julie said when she first came in here to work with me, because she used to be a teacher, she's got 2 master's degrees, but she used to be a teacher. I said, you're overqualified for what you do. I said, I need you in this office. You need to be helping us over here. And I've been very happy ever since. But she came in, and I remember the first year we had about 8 people pass away from our client base. And she goes, you didn't tell me about this. I can't take this part of it. And, you know, the way we do things, it's a boutique firm. So we do a lot of client appreciation events together. Mm-hmm. Everybody becomes kind of like a family member here at McPherson Financial Group. And she's like, I don't like this part of the business. It's too hard. I go, yeah, that is the one that doesn't, it's not a lot of fun. However, that's one of my greatest feelings, is I can look at a husband in the eye and say, hey, when I'm gone, make sure my wife's okay. And we do that, you know, and the wives are okay. And sometimes the wives are not used to doing a lot of that, because you usually have one person in the family that's really, really good with the finances. And a lot of times the wives will let the husbands do that. Now, there a lot of times will be reversed too. But we absolutely make sure that spouse is doing extremely well and can make sure that their whole retirement program, nothing changes, everything's still there, because you still need that income. You know, the rule of thumb is about 75% of the income, but your expenses don't go in half, Mark. They only go down about 25%. So you still need that retirement income at the same level.
And we appreciate Jameson Rodgers for spending a little bit of time with us here this weekend on The Art of Money. And you can hear that again, plus more, when you download the Art of Money podcast. It is available across all podcast platforms. And just so you know, Jameson Rodgers, his new album is called Bet You're From a Small Town. I bet we'll be hearing more from him after too long.
Thanks for listening. Want more from Art McPherson of McPherson Financial Group? Find us online at artofmoneyradio.com. We are an independent financial services firm helping individuals create retirement strategies using a variety of financial and insurance products to custom suit their needs and objectives. Securities offered through World Equity Group, Inc., member FINRA and SIPC, a registered investment advisor. Investment advisory services offered through ProStatus Group, LLC. McPherson Financial Group and ProStatus Group, LLC are separate entities and are not owned or controlled by World Equity Group, Inc. Exposure to ideas and financial vehicles discussed should not be considered investment advice or recommendation to buy or sell any financial vehicle. Past performance is not a guarantee of future results. Investments can fluctuate and when redeemed may be worth more or less than when originally invested. Investment financial professionals are not licensed in all 50 states. Art McPherson is not affiliated with nor endorsed by the Social Security Administration or any other government agency and does not provide legal or tax advice. Please consult with your attorney, accountant, and or tax advisor for advice concerning your particular circumstances. Annuity guarantees rely solely on the financial strength and claims paying ability of the issuing insurance company. By contacting us, you may be provided with information about insurance and annuity products offered through Arthur McPherson. Florida Insurance License Number A1 174725.
Today's show has been a work of art.